In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world. They resound with God's own heart. Oh, let the ancient words in.
For our goodnight message on this Monday, the 21st of November 2022, broadcasting from the Salesian community of the Sacred Heart in Lusaka, Zambia, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this encouraging message in line with the gospel passage of today entitled Lessons from the Poor Widow. Today we read from Luke chapter 21, verse 1 to 4. It is about Jesus in Jerusalem and in the temple and watching those who were putting their gifts into the offering box. He noticed a widow, a poor widow, who just gave the little she had, but she gave it with her heart. There are several lessons to be learned from this narrative. First, God is not so much concerned with the amount we give, but the spirit with which we give it. Any gift that is given grudgingly loses its value. Regarding the campaign that Paul raised for the church in Jerusalem, the poor church in Jerusalem, he said this to the Corinthians in 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 7, "Each one must give as he has made up his mind, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver." The Greek word for cheerful is hilaros. You immediately see we derive the word hilarious from this word. What some people give is hilarious, but not in a good way. Giving should be cheerful and joyful. We have heard the expression, "Give until it hurts." How about giving until it feels good? The second lesson we learn from the poor widow is giving involves sacrifice. When considered against all other Bible passages on giving and the use of money, Jesus is not teaching that we should put our last dollar into the treasury. We must have funds to support our families, pay our bills, and make sure that our children are in school. Apart from our church contribution, our opportunities to individually help others are taught in several Bible passages, in Galatians chapter 6 verse 10, in Ephesians chapter 4 verse 28, in James chapter 1 verse 27. To the wealthy the Bible exhorts, "Let them do good that they be rich in good works, ready to give, willing to share." 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 18. All giving involves some element of sacrifice. Because we have given up whatever personal pleasure we could have enjoyed with that money, but there are times that calls for greater sacrifice to dig deep, to meet a pressing need, whether in the church or in some worthy cause that we support. The first century Christians actually sold properties to meet an urgent benevolent need among their brethren. Acts chapter 4 verse 34 to 37. The third lesson we draw from today's story is giving demonstrates our faith in God. The widow in the narrative gave all that she had. Where was her next meal coming from? How would she live? What would she do to make both ends meet? We don't know, but it does show her faith that God would provide. The Bible teaches the principle of sowing and reaping. Regarding our giving, Paul wrote, "Remember this, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows generously will also reap generously." 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 6. Like David of old, "I've not seen the righteous forsaken, nor the descendants begging bread." Psalm 37 verse 25. Giving is an opportunity to support what we believe in, to see it continue, prosper, and grow, to have fellowship with others in a common cause, to share God's blessings, and to use our resources to do good. The amount is not as important in God's eyes as the attitude behind it. As James Russell wrote, "It's not what we give, but what we share, for the gift without the giver is bare." Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.
Come.